At 89 years old, Roger Harrington, retired now for 20 years, is still a household name among engineers. He is the author of one of the most quoted books in all of physics, having been cited nearly 7,000 times in published academic literature. But this author's story begins long before he was born, more than a century ago, a time when the universe was brimming with dark and mysterious forces. Generally speaking, we wouldn't consider them mysterious today. But in the 1800s, the interconnected nature of electricity, magnetism, and light was still unknown to scientists, until James Maxwell helped unify the forces as manifestations of the same phenomena. Electromagnetism. The rules that govern the flow of electric current, the behavior of light, and magnetic forces could be described with just four equations, later known as Maxwell's equations. These scribblings would unlock the door to what we consider the technologically modern world, but it would take another leap forward to open it. The problem? For engineers, Maxwell's equations are virtually unsolvable.
Maxwell's equations presented problems for early electrical engineers struggling to create efficient electromagnetic technologies like radio antennas. Here's why. Maxwell's equations can describe how, for example, radio waves move through space and bounce off a perfect object in that space, like this box. Maxwell's equations, which physicists call differential equations, are designed to determine how each changing force in a physical system interacts with other forces. Here's a loose analogy. You can think of the areas where our radio waves strike the surface of our box as important for engineers to consider in their calculations. But here's the problem. Objects in real life don't have perfect surfaces. Large and small imperfections cause the electromagnetic waves to scatter in all directions. Add other objects, a few more radio waves, and you can see how Maxwell's equations are virtually impossible to solve in a real-life scenario. The complexity meant that mid-century electrical engineers had trouble developing efficient versions of technologies important to the time, like radar.
Nowhere was a solution to these engineering challenges more needed than in the U.S. military, where 19-year-old Navy electrical engineer Roger Harrington, a recent graduate from Syracuse University, puzzled over the problem.
Well, Maxwell, he didn't write the equations down in very useful form.
Harrington spent years striving to find a solution, until one day an idea struck him. If he couldn't solve Maxwell's differential equations, he would convert them to a form he could solve, a type of equation mathematicians call a matrix equation.
We can always solve matrix equations. We can't solve differential equations, all of them. I got a method of solving them.
Harrington spent years learning and developing matrix conversion techniques, compiling them into a mathematical opus, a universal method of converting Maxwell's equations to manageable forms, all solvable on a digital computer. He called his book Field Computation by Moment Methods. And with it, and the two books that followed, he changed the world.
A lot of people were doing it at the time, and I tried to put it into one method, and I came up with the method of moments.
Harrington's work became the key to Maxwell's equations for engineers. Nearly every device that receives or transmits an electromagnetic signal, from radios to televisions to the smartphone in your pocket, has been made possible by the work of Roger Harrington.
The equations and formulas put forth in his work are the cornerstone in today's complex world of electronics. The world as we know it today would be a vastly different place without him.